I knew I wanted to be an actor when I was about 9 years old. I was 9 years old and I knew I wanted to be an actor. So my first audition was for a Pepsi commercial. Yes, it was for a Pepsi commercial. I was 12. And it went horribly. It was so bad. It was awful. As you can imagine, I didn't get it. What I like most about the industry is that the people in it are so supportive of one another. I think that's such a beautiful thing, and this industry, as hard as it is to make it in this industry, you know, being there for one another in the industry just makes the process so much more easier and fun and better. I also love the people in my industry. They're all so amazing and great, I guess. Creative minds. I'm drawn more to the dramatic characters. Like, I'm not on the comedy side of the industry, no. I'm drawn more to the dramatic characters and the traumatized characters. So I'm working on this show currently called Sonder. Just check it out. It's great. The first season is already out. It's pretty great. And I play Savannah, and she's like a very sweet, driven, lively girl. She's very confident in herself, and she spreads love and positivity to her friends and family and everyone around her. And so she inspires me to do the same. She honestly inspires me to be confident and to be spread positivity and love and joy. I've overcome many of the weaknesses I had as an actor over the years, which were performing in front of, you know, executives and producers and directors and casting directors and stuff. Something I'm still struggling with, I guess, is voicing my opinion. Like, you know, I struggle with voicing my opinion when I'm on set, when I'm not on set, when I'm doing press, or when I'm talking to an executive producer on the show. I'm really good at communicating. I'm really good at understanding those that I work with and listening to them. And I'm really good at, you know, memorizing my lines, being on time. You know, when I say I'm gonna do something, I'm gonna do it. So I guess that's a strength I have as an actor, and it's a very valued one in the industry. For me personally, very personally, the hardest part about being an actor is the constant anxiety about, you know, what's gonna happen next. Because this is not a profession where it's guaranteed. You know, I don't like saying that, it scares me literally. But it's not a profession where it's guaranteed. You're only as good as your last thing, you know. One of my favorite actors said that, Ben Affleck. You're only as good as the last thing you did. So I'm always kind of reaching for more, always aiming for more, always looking for more. You know, there's no top to an actor. There's no top, you know. So really what inspired me to do it was the confidence and the belief that I had, and of course the actors that I looked up to. Ben Affleck and Casey Affleck, the brothers, and John Krasinski and Matthew McConaughey and George Clooney and Angelina Jolie and those are like the big guys, but there's also some small actors out there that I just are so extremely inspiring and extraordinary and amazing at what they do, and I just, not a lot of people know them, like you know, like Marcy Martin or McKenna Grace or Noah Jupe or Millicent Simmons. Those are all like kids my age. They're all very young. They're like kids my age, and the fact that they're doing this so successfully and they've sort of made it in their career already, they're up there, it's nothing but an inspiration. It's such a huge inspiration. It only makes me believe that I can do it even more. I aspire to be like that.